Good morning and welcome to worship here at Highland Valley United Methodist Church. We are so thrilled that you have joined us for worship today and hope that you receive a blessing by being a part of our service. It's really, really important for us to like, comment, and share the service with others in order that we can witness to the good news in better ways as we continue to be in virtual worship with one another. So if you would just take out your phone right now and share the worship service with your friends on Facebook, if you have a Facebook account, that would just be wonderful. I have a very important announcement for you today. The relaunch team and the trustees have made a decision that we will begin in-person worship here at Highland Valley on November 1st. And the worship time will change to 11 a.m. And Sunday school by Zoom will change to 9 a.m. starting November 1st. Here are just a few things you might want to listen to and receive, but you will be receiving more information by email and it will be available on the website. We will need to have persons registered to attend by answering some screening questions before they come. You will be checked in upon arrival, temperature documented. You must wear a mask at all times. Parishioners will be escorted to seats beginning at the front of the church and moving toward the back, and there will be different ways to enter and exit in that way. And there are a limited number of spaces available. So you might need to remember that if you don't register and come to be a part of worship, there might not be a seat available by the time you arrive. One of the things we really would like to encourage is that we all pray that things will go well as we begin to come back on campus and be present with one another, that all will stay safe. And if you have any questions, please call or email the church office. So we are really, really, really excited about being able to be back in the sanctuary together for worship. We will, however, also continue our online presence as well. So now let us center down and take a moment to prepare our hearts and our minds to receive the blessing of God's word and God's presence with us today. Will you bow with me in prayer? O God, our Maker, you created us in your image and formed us in infinite variety. You value every creature, each person, and especially on this Children's Sabbath, we ask your blessings upon all children and for a world in which each of them will learn that they are valued by you. Startle us, O God, with renewed awareness of human diversity. Challenge us to receive your gift with humility and grace. O Christ of redemption, you teach us to love one another, and we receive this as a problem in our education. Forgive our ignorance and move us to changes that can come only through wholesale reform. Grant us your boldness to take committed action that ends systemic racial injustice. O Spirit of holiness, you pour upon us the fire of your mercy and form us into community. Let us be a movement for equality and send us beyond our safety nets of conversation and conventionality. Lift us above our narrow understandings. Help us to embrace new ways of being. Show us the pathway of reconciliation and reveal anew your vision of a kingdom of peace. In Christ's name we pray, amen.
Please join with me in singing our hymn of praise. Be not dismayed, whatever betide, God will take care of you. Beneath his wings of love abide, God will take care of you. God will
Good morning, everyone. This month, we hope we are helping you lay the foundation for a life with Christ and in Christ. This is our third week to hear from the Sermon on the Mount, and this one's a long one. It has a lot of information, a lot of stuff, so listen closely. But I'm going to focus in on one thing because I've already been thinking about this year. My kids are already telling me, some of you probably are already telling your families too, Mom, 74 days till Christmas, 73 days until Christmas. There's an app on their phone that counts down to the very second. And parents, don't go by this because I wrote this on Monday, so you're a few days behind. It's not 76 days anymore. But I've already started lists on my phone. When they tell me something, I have a little folder and I type it. I've already started thinking about all the stuff. And then going through old books to donate to the book drive, I found one of my favorites, the longest Christmas list ever. And this kind of got me thinking about all that stuff too. In this story, the little boy Trevor doesn't get what he wants for Christmas. So he starts his Christmas list that very day. And it takes up pages and notebooks and boxes. And then it gets so long, he tries to take it to the post office, and it goes all the way down the street from the post office all the way back to his house. All this stuff that he wants. All this stuff that we think we need all the time. And it's only October, so parents, I'm not trying to stress you out. Kids, calm down. But this scripture did get me thinking about all this stuff. And I have things that I want. And I have things that I love, like my phone and my computer. Those are things that I can't do my work without. We all have things that we love. We all have treasures. But the problem comes when we're like Trevor and we're so focused on the treasures that we have on earth that that's the only thing we think about. And Jesus does not want that kind of life for us. That is not the joy that Jesus has planned for us, worrying all the time about stuff and treasures. So Jesus tells us, don't store up our treasures on earth. Don't think about yourself. Don't worry about having everything that you need. Don't worry about anything. You need to have your treasures stored in heaven. And your treasures in heaven are the things you're doing right now to help others. So that would be donating books to the book drive or giving food to the food pantry or helping Mr. Bill in the garden or standing up for what's right or being brave. Those are the things that Jesus wants us to focus on. That's the kind of life of service that Jesus wants us to have. So this week, think of others, see and start serve, and instead of all that long list of stuff that you want the kingdom of heaven more than anything. And I just want to read you I'm not going to give the story away. You know I don't do that, but I think Trevor sums it up. His prior mistake was now perfectly clear. It takes love, not stuff, to bring Christmas cheer. Let's pray. Lord, thank you for all the gifts you've given me on earth and the treasures that await us in heaven. Help me seek first your kingdom, not my own. Teach me to help your kingdom, not my own. Help me walk by your word, not by selfishness. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Good morning. I am so glad you are joining with us. Let us prepare to go to the Word of God, turn in your Bibles or read on the screen or your electronic instruments to the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 6. Our reading will begin with verse 19 and we'll read through verse 33. Again, Matthew chapter 6, verse 19 through 33. Reading from God's Word translation. Stop storing up treasures for yourselves on earth, where moth and rust destroys and thieves break in and steal. Instead, store up treasures for yourselves in heaven, where moth and rust don't destroy and thieves don't break in and steal. Your heart will be where your treasure is. The eye is the lamp of the body. So if your eye is unclouded, your whole body will be full of light. But if your eye is evil, your whole body will be full of darkness. If the light in you is darkness, how dark it will be. No one can serve two masters. He will hate the first master and love the second, or he will be devoted to the first and despise the second. You cannot serve God and wealth. So I tell you to stop worrying about what you will eat, drink, or wear. Isn't life more than food and the body more than clothes? Look at the birds. They don't plant, harvest, or gather the harvest into barns. Yet your heavenly Father feeds them. Aren't you worth more than they? Can any of you add a single hour to your life by worrying? And why worry about clothes? Notice how the flowers grow in the field. They never work or spin yarns for clothing. But I say that not even Solomon in all of his majesty was dressed like one of these flowers. That's the way God clothed the grass in the field. Today, it's alive, and tomorrow, it's thrown into the incinerator. So how much more will he clothe you, people who have so little faith? Don't ever worry and say, what are we going to eat, or what are we going to drink, or what are we going to wear? Everyone is concerned about these things, and your heavenly Father certainly knows you need all of them. But first, be concerned about his kingdom and what has his approval. Then all these things will be provided for you. So the word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. There are some puzzling and challenging sayings in this pericope of text. However, a close look reveals that Jesus was presenting a consistent and a persistent idea. And that idea is based upon priorities. So that's what I've entitled this message for today. The idea of priorities. The priorities that should distinguish Christians from other cross sections of people. Jesus unfolds the idea that we should be carefully examining our primary passion in life, our true devotion. In verse 24, the idea of trying to serve two masters is presented. Trying to serve two controlling passions. In this case, the two are contrary to each other. For one is earthly and the other is heavenly. One is temporary, the other is eternal. And though this is understood by so many in this world, Yet how easy it is to lose sight of this. How easy it is to allow temporary things to take primary place in our lives. How easy it is to allow the strong passion for things of this world to divide our loving devotion to God. In verse 24, the words love and hate are used. Hate, as used here, signifies to love less. Really, it is a matter of neglecting time with God because there are so many other things to do. Neglecting to use your blessings that God has given to you. Neglecting to follow and to serve God with all of our being. It is vital that our love for God increases in ways that helps to adjust our love and passion for the things of this world. It is our love for the closeness of God that must increase. It is paramount that our love for God is primary in our lives and in our relationship with God. The strophe rhythm of this text calls upon us to prioritize. This is about each of us examining ourselves, not about judging others. Jesus knew what his audience was facing. He knew the temptation. So Jesus is probing into the heart and into the minds of that community, asking them to identify their value center. The value center that indicates one's true passion and true love. Now, the caution is this. You cannot have two primary value centers, or as the text puts it, two masters. Now, Jesus doesn't call us to be carefree about provisions, but to be free of worrying, consumed, and controlled by our thinkings about these things. Verse 25 says, therefore, I tell you, do not worry what you will eat or what you will drink. But how? How do we not worry? Well, by remembering the Lord is master of this universe, by remembering his love for you and for us, I believe God has assigned this relevant message for our time together this morning. What abyss of worry, of fearfulness, of anxiety could God be calling you back from right now? Those worries that seems to always be there, always closing in upon you, matters that impedes your peace of mind. We live in a time that is proliferated with the suggestion that things are falling apart. Yet, Jesus utilizes these words to give balance to our lives. Jesus understood the impact that these things of the world can have upon us. He understood how we can lose ourselves in desire, lose ourselves in passion, and lose ourselves in the thirst for these things. But the prohibition of Jesus is, therefore, take no thought saying, what we will, shall we eat, or what shall we drink, or what shall we wear? Listen to verse 26. Look at the birds of the air. They neither sow nor gather into barns, and yet your heavenly Father feeds them. Are you not of more value than they? However, Jesus told them, and he tells us, not to worry, for life is more important than physical things. When we put God first in our lives, he stabilizes us. Friend, what we have received from the unmerited bounty of God should never separate us from the God who provides such things. Verse 21, where your treasure is, there will your loyalty be also. If God be the treasure of our souls, of our hearts, of our affection, and of our desire, then we are storing up things in heaven, in a place where neither moth nor rust comes in and corrupt. If you look around, you will find plenty of reasons to worry. The sun beams might cause cancer, air vents, blowing lung clotting mold around, worry, potato chips having too many carbs, worry, vegetables having too many toxins, the economy is going to crash, the bridge is out, the sky is going to fall, on and on the list of worrying goes. We go to sleep worrying, then we want to wake up refreshed and revived, but worry sets in. We drive worrying. What might happen? We walk and we worry. Worrying seems to penetrate our lives on a daily basis. But these words of Jesus should ring relevant and should ring as a place of stability, a foundation of firmness, that God who takes care of the birds of the air, God who clothes the flowers of the field, God who causes the waters to run, that God will take care of our every need. Worry? Sure, if our priority on the things of this world, but if they're on God, then we can rest assured he'll take care of us. I want you to be blessed, grow closer to God, so that worrying can move further away. Go in peace.
We are so very grateful for all of the ways that the Highland Valley United Methodist family continues to bless and support the ministries and mission here at our church. So now, as we listen to the offertory song, it is a wonderful time for those of you who would like to do so to contribute to the missions of this church by going to hvumc.org/give. As we prepare now, remember that that we are blessed to be a blessing, and it is wonderful that you have shared your blessings with us.
So please join me in singing our final hymn. Where
Oh, how true those words are. If it had not been for the Lord on my side, where would I be? We're coming to the close of this worship service, but I want you to know Jesus in a personal way. So I make this invitation that if you've not received Him as Lord and Savior of your life, that you would do so. And that then you can rest assured in your day-to-day living and going that God will take care of your every need. And He's on your side. Be blessed. We'll see you next time.